Welcome to Home Day, where we make all your decor dreams come true. Today we are going to start by talking about hobby decorating. Please welcome Kimberley Seldon, our designer off the top of the show.
Courtesy of LT.
I love your
And when you say
room.
Hobby decorating, I want to make it clear that we're not talking about people who decorate for a hobby, which is something very different, and we like that too.
Right.
But people who are excited and have a passion about something in their life, and they want their home or a room to reflect that passion and that hobby.
Right. So like if you're into the circus, you could have a circus room.
Could maybe not.
Actually, don't ever do that. We want to talk about the right way to do it.
My husband's into hockey, so a lot of guys will have a man cave. I saw the most amazing man cave recently. They had like hockey jerseys hanging on the wall and all that stuff, and it was in the basement, and that's where that kind of room belongs.
Right.
This is not the basement. This is your living room. So when you're talking about decorating a room that's prime real estate in your house, a very important place for everybody who comes in, where you hang out with your family and friends, I believe my philosophy is when it comes to incorporating a hobby, you want to do it subtly.
Right.
You don't want to hit them over the head. This is not the Epcot Center. And you've landed in the Moroccan room.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, so, it shouldn't be literal.
No, don't make it literal, but use inspiration from your hobby. So in this case, we decided that our phantom client had a beautiful horse, and I have friends who have horses, and they ride on the weekend, and they go visit their horses, and like they're part of the family. They're a very important part of the family.
Yeah.
So in that case, one of the things you can think about is there a designer who sort of has that vibe and that feeling? Ralph Lauren comes to mind. So we decided this is going to be kind of an homage to Ralph Lauren.
Nice.
We started with a beautiful area carpet from LT. Again, it has nothing to do with horses, but it certainly is a piece that you could build a room around confidently.
You're almost looking for the tone of it, right? So it fits the tone.
Yeah, and you're thinking about those warm leathers, those saddles, and that rustic wood that you might find in a stable. And not like, we've seen those reality decorating shows where they put hay on the wall. Don't do that.
No.
Don't do that.
Don't go there.
That is not a good look. Nobody likes that look.
No.
Instead, you're going to look for pieces that look well worn and have leather accents like this coffee table.
This is so cool.
Now, it looks vintage. It looks old, but in fact, it's got this great set of drawers.
So it's
really good storage. Much better than, the type of trunks that you lift up and then they come crashing down on someone's fingers.
Yes.
So really smart. Huge amount of storage. So this would even work for a small space. Leather sofa is kind of a given if you're thinking about a tack room or a horsey kind of environment. Yeah. Really comfortable. Guys feel comfortable in the leather as well. And when you want it, you want the yin and the yang. So because this is very masculine, again, the carpet has a more feminine feel. It's got
Absolutely.
A little bit of color.
So the chairs, you do have also, little horsey sprawled throughout.
This is so sweet.
Looks good.
This used to be on Jarvis in Toronto, they would have these posts that were topped with these horse heads so you could tie your horse. And this is a vintage piece that we found. It's mine. I brought it from home, but
that's amazing.
I love it. That's what I would do if I was a horsey person as well.
Yes, that is a very smart, that's a
Isn't
really
that
nice
cool?
buy. And then these as well, are these from LT?
These are from LT, the leather books, a console table. So what I like to do when I'm thinking about somebody who has a personality, I like rooms that have a bit of the homeowner's personality. To me, that makes the most sense. I like to create a mood. I want to evoke an atmosphere. In this case, it's not a sunny beach house. It's a cozy, comfortable, put your feet up, read a leather book kind of a room. And so if you make every decision when you're decorating through that lens, is this cozy, comfortable, casual, that kind of space, then you'll be able to choose a buffet or console table that makes sense for the look you're trying to create.
Yeah, and it's not about just throwing up a big picture of a horse, although there are some beautiful big pictures of horses.
In fact, it's so funny, I brought one to a customer and she really didn't like it.
So
you're going to have a strong reaction and a strong opinion to art, and you should.
Yeah.
I think it's emotional. This piece is beautiful. To me, it sort of evokes a birch tree, but if you look at that and you feel flat and you feel cold, then it's not the right choice for you.
That's
right. And don't let anybody talk you into it.
No, art cannot be talked into.
No, no, no.
It's you like it or you don't. You almost have a visceral reaction
exactly.
to it, right? Positive
and then
or negative.
When it comes to lighting, you know, we talk a lot about hag lighting, just relying heavily on those overhead pots that just relentlessly shine light on down the top of your head and make you look tired.
They give you bags.
The table lamp or the floor lamp is your best friend. It puts light right where you need it. And when you're trying to create drama in a space, go for black lampshades. Mm-hmm. Cozy drama black lampshades. And remember with a black lampshade, it will kind of force light down versus sending it throughout the whole space. So you also want to make sure it's lighting something worthwhile. These lamps, I think, are stunning. So in that case, it's really going to direct your attention to the brass that you see on the lamps.
Well, I'm worthwhile, so I would just walk around with it in my hand at all times.
I'm about at the stage where I just want to walk around with a candle. Pretty much.
Two candles.
Kimberly, I can't see.
Here.
You're fine. You'll adjust. It'll be good.